Hello learners, in this video we will discuss about fully exempted allowances. Meaning of allowance. Allowance means any sum allowed regularly. Allowance is the payments in cash given to an employee by his or her employer monthly along with salary. It is a fixed amount paid regularly for the purpose of meeting some specific type of requirements or to help employee connected with the service. Allowances are categorized into three types on the basis of their tax treatment point of view. Number one, taxable allowances. Number two, allowances exempt up to specified limit. And number three, fully exempted allowances. Fully taxable allowances like DNS allowance, DNS pay, city compensatory allowance, fixed medical allowance, stipend allowance, servant allowance, all these are fully taxable allowances. The link of this video is in the description box. These are taxable unless specifically exempted by government notification. Whatever the amount is given regarding these allowance or allowances, that amount is a part of salary or considered to be a part of total income. For example, if Mr. Dilip Vedi is a government employee and he is getting basic salary of rupees 60,000 per month and rupees 1,000 per month as medical allowance, then his total salary shall be 61,000 per month. That is rupees 60,000 plus 1,000 is equal to rupees 61,000. Allowances exempt up to specified limit are partially taxable allowances. Under this, number one is house rent allowance, entertainment allowance, special allowances for meeting certain expenses. This part will be discussed in the next video. The link is in the description box. Now, we will discuss fully exempted allowances. Fully exempted allowance means that this particular allowance shall not be a part of salary or total income. The allowances which are fully exempted are neither included in the total income or nor they are taxable. The following are fully exempted allowances. Number one. Foreign allowance paid by government to its employees who are posted abroad. Number two, sumptuary allowance given to judges of High Court and Supreme Court. Number three, house rent allowance given to judges of High Court and Supreme Court. Number four, compensatory allowance given to judges of High Court and Supreme Court. And number five, allowance for UN employees paid by UNO. Now, it's a time for assignment. What do you mean by the term allowances? Number two, write a short note on allowances which are fully exempted. I would like to express my gratitude to Sanatan Dharam College, Ambala Kent, for providing me an opportunity to learn e-content development and making these videos. I salute you, all the team members, for sharing and providing a platform to develop this skill. Thank you very much. Keep learning. It's a need of our. Stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.